Hey there, my name is Donovan Mesa. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I haven't been here in a fat minute to just sit down and talk. I want to start getting back into the groove of making YouTube videos though, and I thought, what better way to do that than to start off with a Q&A? You know, it's been a while since I've just sat down and talked about what's going on in my life and stuff, and yeah, so that's what I'm here to do. If you didn't know already, in November of 2019, I moved out to LA to go to the Los Angeles Film School. And it's been really fun. I'm learning a lot. And that's honestly, like, basically it. That's my whole update. I've just been learning for the past 9 months. I mean, obviously haven't been going to campus for, reasons I don't need to explain. But I'm still learning a bunch, and I'm excited to apply that to future videos as well. I know I made the change a while back to start moving away from sort of content like this, but, it's been really difficult to make the type of content that I wanted to make back then, just because of how labor-intensive it is. And also the fact that I would need some sort of event going on in order for me to make any sort of content. And yeah, it's impossible to rely on that. So, here we are. But I asked for your questions on Instagram, and I got responses! What do you know? Okay, so first question, here we go. Not a question, but a doctor accidentally puts his doctor's coat in the dryer for too long, so when he puts it on, his balls hang out. Next question, what's the strangest thing you've experienced or seen while living in LA? It's really hard to choose because there's been a lot. I mean, I've only been here for 9 months and I've already come across way too many strange experiences. One of the ones that like sticks in my brain though, I was walking down Sunset Boulevard past my school when I saw a guy who looked relatively normal at first, pretty normal, just normal dude, walking, just, you know, everyday guy. And then all of a sudden, when I was about 10 feet from him, he starts sprinting forward, screaming, and just yelling obscenity after obscenity. I naturally sped up. So, okay, later, I reach my destination, which is about a couple blocks ahead, and I'm standing in line, and then I see the guy walking from behind like he had circled around the entire block and made his way back to conveniently where I was, and still doing the same thing, just screaming at the top of his lungs, you know. Guy's obviously bonkers, right? So as he's approaching the line and screaming, then he sees the line and then quiets and just casually stands in line. And there was no other incident with that guy. Okay, next question is one that's pretty commonly asked. Is a hot dog a sandwich or a taco? I think we have to look at the definition of both words to really determine. Taco, definition. Sandwich. Definition. Okay, a taco is a Mexican dish consisting of fried tortilla, typically folded, filled with various mixtures such as seasoned meat, beans, lettuce, and tomatoes. So clearly a hot dog cannot be a taco. It just doesn't meet the criteria. There's no way. A sandwich, however, is an item of food consisting of two pieces of bread with meat, cheese, or other filling between them, eaten as a light meal. Okay, now here's a follow-up question. Is the bun two pieces of bread, or is it one piece of bread that folds? I don't know. You tell me. I'm not here to tell you if a hot dog is a sandwich or not. Okay? I'm just saying, a bun isn't really two breads. Think about that one. Next question. Favorite brand of chip? I don't know. There's so many chips, and they're all pretty good. You know what? Discard the question. Instead, I'm just gonna put you on right now. Tomato basil wheat thins. Not even joking. Not a chip, I know. Pretty much a cracker, but you know, it is a cracker, right? Wait, what is this? Snacks. It's just called a snack? No, this is a cracker, right? Okay, wait. Is a wheat thin a cracker? Okay, yeah, a wheat thin is a cracker. I'm disappointed that I had to search it up, but you know what? We're thinking about how food qualifies as other food, you know? It's already on the brain. That's just been like my favorite type of snacky food right now, for sure. Ooh ee ooh ah, bing bang, walla walla. Ooh, that, no, you got the lyrics wrong. Oh, sorry, my guy. Come on, it's ooh ee ooh ah ah, ting tang, walla walla, bing bang. Not bing bang, walla walla, bing bang. You don't rhyme bing bang with bing bang, you rhyme ting tang with bing bang. Yes, that's Michael Jordan on my shirt, okay? Leave me alone. I got it at a thrift store 3 years ago. I don't even watch basketball. Have you ever had a cat as a best friend? So, not really. I'm more of a dog person for sure. Every cat like I've ever been around has been irritated with me. I don't know. I feel like it's partially because of me not knowing what to do. Especially how to, like, hold them. I feel like cats don't even like being held in the first place, but maybe that's just me. But, like, I have a history with cats. Like, when I was in second grade, I was asleep on the couch, and the cat jumped up on my face, and then jumped off of the back of the couch, and used my face as a launch pad, and dug her claws right into my face, and I had, like, 3 huge cat scratches all the way down my face. But I kind of thought it made me look like Anakin Skywalker, and I was like, that's cool a little bit. Same cat, about a year later, diarrhea'd on my head. Oh, and I was wearing a new shirt at the time too. I just gotten the shirt, I think that day or like the day before or something like that. And literally just, I think I held her over my head and then she just like, but after that, I mean, I haven't really wanted to associate with cats much. And we had multiple cats as a kid and they all, like, did something to me. Scratched me, did... Zelda's never bitten me. Braxton's never bitten me. So, first choice place to travel anywhere in the world, and why? It's a hard question. Also because I'm really bad at geography, but Iceland looks nice. Hawaii's great. Ireland. There's so many places in the world to go. I wouldn't even know where to start. But I'd love to travel someday. I've never been outside of California, Nevada, and Arizona. How are you human? Simply. I didn't have to try. I didn't do anything to become human, okay?
Oh no, my cover's been blown.
What's your choice of career in a parallel universe where there's no such thing as a video camera? Uh-oh. Whoa. It's honestly, like, I haven't thought about it a whole lot. I am interested in, like, ancient history, so maybe I'd go into something like that, or archaeology or something like that. But I mean, really, there are... I mean, you know, we're in the universe where there's video cameras, so I don't have to worry about it. but look forward to more videos. I'm working on another one right now, right as we speak, right as this video is being uploaded, I'm editing another video. Productive. My brain doesn't let me make content that I'm not interested in. So if I suddenly become uninterested in the type of content I'm making, it's very likely that I just instantly fall off.